Welcome to our 89th presentation of the Singing Christmas Tree. I'm Roger Parrott, president of Belhaven University. It was on this campus so many years ago that the first outdoor singing Christmas tree in the world was presented. And having to take a break from COVID, we are especially glad to welcome you back to campus this evening. We appreciate the Belhaven University Band for getting us to the Christmas spirit as we prepare for this performance and the tradition of starting Christmas in Mississippi. And to get you ready for Christmas, also we are thankful for First Presbyterian Church for providing free hot chocolate for you tonight. And while our focus is on Christmas, New Year's resolutions are probably around the corner, and if your resolution is getting back to church, you couldn't find a better church home than the people of First Presbyterian and the biblically grounded messages of Dr. David Strain. Well, tonight, we appreciate all of you working around our construction on campus. We've taken away the temporary building shipping containers we use to operate the stadium and are building a beautiful brick permanent building in its place. And in the parking lot behind the flagpole, we're beginning the construction of a 400-space parking garage. With all that's going on, we are especially thankful for the marvelous work of SoundCom, who has gone to great lengths to provide sound this evening without the normal electronics of the stadium and the Jumbotron. And we deeply appreciate the lights and technology engineered by Belhaven alum, Mr. E.C. Harp, who for 52 years has been leading the system that brings sparkle to this Christmas tree performance. Well, Belhaven University serves over 4,000 students through our 70 undergraduate academic programs, master's degrees in business, health administration, education, biblical studies, sports administration, and dance, and doctoral programs in educational leadership, and our newest doctorate in business administration. But in light of tonight's concert, what's most important for you to know about Belhaven is that this university is only one of 36 in America that have achieved national accreditation in all four of the major arts, music, theater, visual art, and dance, along with robust programs in arts, including graphic design, film production, and creative writing. And we're the only Christian university in America working at this level in the arts. Before we begin, I have an important reminder for families with active children who are excited to be in a football stadium. Tonight is a concert, not an athletic event. So as a courtesy to all who come to enjoy the music, please quiet your children beside you. Don't let them run and wander, because the performers will also be among you. And then we can focus on the performance and let the music fill our spirit with the joy of Christmas. We celebrate the birth of Jesus, who came to earth to walk among us and teach us, to offer his life, to redeem us from our sin, and to restore us in love with the holy God who made us. As a Christ-centered university, our faith in God is at the center of all we do, and so it's fitting that this campus is especially known for this wonderful tradition of Christian music. On behalf of Dr. Andy Sauerwein, Chair of the Music Department, I'm pleased to welcome our director, Tim Walker, the Belhaven University students, alumni, and friends as we present the 89th Annual Singing Christmas Tree. Merry Christmas.
Making spirits bright, what fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells.
We do indeed wish you a Merry Christmas. What an exciting way to kick off the 89th Belhaven Singing Christmas Tree. My name is LaHenry, and I will be your host for the evening. This is the time of the year that people all around look forward to celebrating Christmas trees. Lights and all the decorations, parties, presents, children, and family gatherings are all things that come to our minds when we think about Christmas. But this holiday is no ordinary holiday. It is so much more than all those wonderful things. You see, over 2,000 years ago, a young couple would be the first to celebrate the first Christmas. They were engaged to be married when Mary learned that she would have a son. This would be no ordinary boy. This would be God's own son. Can you imagine all the many thoughts they must have shared, the questions they had, this uncertain future?
Shadows fill our day. Mary and Joseph set aside their personal desires as they stepped out in faith. The Gospel of Luke recounts the story of their journey in this way. Luke 2, 4 through 11 says, "And because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee. He took with him Mary, to whom he was engaged, who was now expecting a child. And while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no lodging available for them. That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified, but the angel reassured them, 'Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all the people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem.'"
Thank you.
When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph. And there was the baby, laying in a manger. After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished, but Mary kept all these things in her heart and thought about them often.
Oh. candle, the whole world can see. And let them know that they can be free. His star is shining, its beam keeps reminding that Jesus is a light to guide you.
The cattle are lowing, the baby.
joy, hope, peace, love. All of these are words we often associate with the coming of the Savior of the world, Jesus Christ. He is indeed the greatest gift ever given to mankind. And though his love, we are promised never-ending peace, hope, and joy. Thank you for joining us tonight. Please join the choir in singing more of our favorite Christmas carols as we conclude this evening. From Belhaven University, to each of you, we truly wish you all a very Merry Christmas and the happiest of New Year's.